Okay, we're back. And I'm gonna put the clamp downs on the everything back on the valve cover before I do anything else to try to figure out why it's not getting fuel. Cleaned up my little pull downs for my valve cover, and the long one, big thick long ones, were chrome, just like the valve cover. They came with the valve cover, evidently. All that grease kept them out. They're not a bit of rust on them or anything. All that grease kept them nice and clean under there, and I'm burning my leg. I'm sitting here trying to pick them up while I'm talking. This is one of those times of day I don't like being on this thing. Okay, can't put anything up in there where I normally put it. My butt can't sit where I normally put it. Okay. But I got all the grease wiped off everything. See, I can't tell where to put this. Where's my hand at? There we go. It's chrome. I thought I got all the crappy stuff off of that one, but I didn't. Looks nice. Okay, so the rest of it don't, because it's still dirty. It's got rust on it though. But I gotta get those loose again. Get my at least my tools are still in the shade of my ladder. If that goes out of the shade, I don't know if it will or not. If that goes out of the shade, I will be able to continue there, but I'm just gonna try to get this done. And then if I can work around the sun and I'm not burning up too bad, I'll keep going. Otherwise I'll have to go in for the day. Don't let me forget to put my, I think I'll put the air cleaner on there. Gives me a place to lay stuff. And I can't drop anything in there by accident if the air cleaner's on it, because I didn't have any trouble getting to that before. There. So I can put the little nut on it too, because sometimes I forget and kind of put my hand on it. That's hot. It's sitting in the sun. Years passed. I worked in this thing for hours with the hood being my only shade. I don't even want to do that kind of stuff anymore. I'm old. I don't care. That one looks kind of short for its purpose. Looks like it wasn't originally for that either. But I've kind of got a mix mash of them. I can see that. Probably. Could have lost some and replaced them, who knows. Don't have any of those long finger spinners. That's on here, that's for sure. That one, that's exactly why I thought I shouldn't lay that up there. Went to pick it up with these stupid gloves, knocked it off instead of picking it up. Now, I think I already hit the ground. Talking about losing them, that's how you lose them. Why I kind of don't put things on the air cleaner anymore. I knew better. Tools? Oh, usually that's okay. Well, take the gloves off. I really just need them to get up and down now. That's the other thing. I wouldn't have dropped it if I wouldn't have had those gloves on. Most likely. The one I dropped is that little bitty short one. Maybe I will get another one that's a little longer. It doesn't look long enough to go through with that washer. It's one of those washers that won't come off. It doesn't look long enough to go through my little keeper. The ones in the top side are stuff I put on there, I'm sure. They're factory style shorter ones. And these long bolts, yeah, I see them. They're matching long bolts. That's probably, I had to use them. And that the chrome keeper is so thick that I probably didn't have room for washers. I think I'll go ahead and put those on there so that it doesn't move. That's the same length, but it's got a washer, lock washer and a washer on it. That little short one looked too short to be in use, really. Oh, I nearly knocked my camera off the wall altogether. I guess it just kind of lifted up and went back down. I think it turned it. Can't even see where it's aiming anymore. There we go. It's aiming pretty much like that. There we go. Just go down a little bit. Okay, this other one, I forgot that it was aiming way down there to look at the spark plugs. Raise it up. Get in my head. Having trouble. Can't look at it with the hood fighting me. Okay. Yeah, this is probably where I can get my best view. And I had it all aimed wrong. At least I thought of it. It's before you couldn't see it because of the way I was doing it, so. Those legs will kind of stay, but at certain points they kind of let go of that tripod. The other one won't do that at all. You can't see, I'm using it on an uneven surface. I can close the leg up so to make it taller on that side. Okay, so do the front one first, I guess. These both long. One of them is longer than the other. I got that one with all the woofers on it. I think it might be longer. I will put the woofers on there, I guess. Yeah, those two are the same length. So, I think I will put them in the long chrome thingies. I'm going to call them that, long chrome thingies. Oh, don't put your knee on the valve cover because it will move it because it's not screwed down. Remember that. Okay, that one's in there pretty good. Gotta put them the right way. They have a big flip up on them. See how thick they are? Pretty good. Of course, those valve covers are pretty thin metal. They're chrome-plated steel. They're not aluminum. I had some aluminum ones, I think, on something that were finned. I really liked those. Okay, now I'm going to put that one right here in. I don't know if I'm going to need that lock washer or not. I think I'll put the lock washer on there because this is a pretty long bolt. Then I'll go get either another one or that one that I dropped. I don't know if it's long enough. Yeah, it looks long enough with the lock washer. I can see this one good, so I'm going to get this one started. Can't see the hole, but well, good thing they have those, you know, those little indentations on the valve cover so that you can get your socket in there, and so that tells you where the hole is, even if you can't see the hole. Okay, now I gotta go under the vehicle, or else go, I guess I'll leave it there. It's gonna get not much to keep things from falling up there, not much there either. That usually falls. I'll put it in my toolbox. It's still shady over there. Okay. Even my rag is getting hot. Okay, I'm gonna go see if I can find a quarter 20. I got some brand new ones, but those aren't strong enough for, you know, bolts for car, from engines are tougher than what you buy at the hardware store, so I don't use those. So I absolutely have to. I don't know that I ever really do. Well, I don't know if you can see my I did use that, but this is plated as to not corrode, and it's for my ground. But that is actually what some bolts I saved in the telco, and they'd be plated with zinc or something. I don't know. It's gold looking, and they don't corrode very quickly. It's been on here 2 years, more, 3 years, and it hasn't corroded one bit. And I used it because I knew that, but also that's all I really had that was any good, would work well. But that's where I put my ground, because that's hard bolted to the motor. Usually I always bolted it to the head or something, but I think there was just like no good way to do it or something. So I put it there, because that alternator bracket don't ever come off. You know, can't drive the car without an alternator. Anyway, it's worked really well. And that is softer, and it could break if you was to overstress it. So I put a wing nut on it so that I could take it off easy, instead of, because it's easier to take that off than the one off the battery. Haven't ever taken it off yet, but okay, let's go get another quarter 20 from somewhere. I don't like that washer being up there. I'm afraid it's going to fall down in the engine or get in the fan in the alternator or something. I used to do that all the time, but also I used to knock them off like I just now did. So maybe I'm getting older and wiser. Oh. I'll be back. Yeah, it's this one back here now that I gotta right up in there. See my bolt. Well, if it's long enough, I guess there's no sense in looking for another one. So let's see how long it looks up next to the little deal that it goes through. But yeah, it has one of those permanent washers on it. Oh, it's long enough. That's why I used it. Alright, well, let's just use it. I don't want to go digging through. It takes a while to find the right bucket over there. Right. Then they'll be dirty and have to be cleaned. I just won't need that washer. A lot quicker. I drink water though. Noticing since I've been filming this whole project here, I tend to work myself harder. I'm always conscious that the camera's waiting on me to come back. And I even hurry when I get a drink of water and hesitate to go get a drink of water. That's kind of dumb, boy. We're just going to stop waiting. But I just naturally do that, you know. I know somebody's waiting on me, so I try to hurry. My gloves up there so that they won't get too hot. Where did I set that thing? Ow, burn. Hey, I can turn this sock right side out, wrong side out. And lean on it. Oh, gosh. Where did I set that thing? Oh, it's right here. I knew it was right there by something. Okay, yeah. All those wires in the way. Get out of the way so I can get that on there. I meant to pull that off and kind of double check that it didn't have crap under it, but you know what? If it leaks, I'll know what to do. I will know what to do. It probably won't, but if it does, take it off, clean it up. If I have to, I'll put some maker gas gasket on there, and if that don't work, I'll have to get a new gasket, new set. And you know what? These don't have to be all that tight. That's why I hold my wrench like that when I'm doing quarter 20s, so that I don't accidentally forget and over tighten. I might do that just a little bit, just keep from hurting my wrist, but if you get to there and it feels really tight, then that's about it. Unless you got some good reason. I'm not saying leave them loose, you get vibration, and of course you don't want your valve cover leaking. But one of the first fun things I did when my first car, I don't know if it's a 64 Chevelle, I remember working on it 350 in Edgewall. But, or it was a Buick Invicta, I don't know, it probably the 64 Chevelle, I don't know that I ever had the valve covers off of that Buick. I wrecked it within a year, I don't know when I think of having it. Got hit crossing Jacksboro Highway. But, okay, that's on there. So anyway, I broke off quarter 20 and the valve cover bolts into the head. I think I broke a couple of them off. It took me a while to learn. Over the years, you know, I probably broke three or four of them in the first 3 years I worked on cars. I only learned to be more, don't torque them down so much. Okay. Oh, but I didn't learn to remember things. What did I just say? Remind me to put that ground strap on there. Nobody said a thing. He just sat there laughing while I did this. And didn't tell me that I forgot the ground strap. I suppose that might be one cool thing if I was doing live videos like I do inside of my desktop. And it was actually able to monitor the chat, somebody was monitoring it for me because I can't do all that at once. And they'd say, hey, you forgot the ground strap. Real quick, that's easy to fix. I may need that. I'm going to need that washer. That washer. And I'm going to need to crawl. Why did I let go of that? I think I'm getting tired. I want that washer because there's a big hole in that ground strip. Unless I put it under that metal thing. No, I don't want to do that. That'll stop it from going down flat on there and spreading out the pressure. I used to have a buddy that was a real good photographer. He didn't know much about cars at all. And I taught him how, you know, but he wasn't very mechanical, but I taught him how to change the oil and fuel filters and all that sort of junk. And he got to where he did that all the time by himself. But when I would go to help him, he usually didn't come out here, but I'd go to his house up in town. Sometimes would work on mine. He'd change the oil for me after he learned how. I wouldn't even have to do it. But anyway, he would hand me tools and hand me stuff I'd drop. So I need a helper. That's what I need. Especially now that I'm old and I can't get up and down good. I gotta crawl under here and get that damn thing. I don't even see it, but the little magnet wouldn't help it stick to everything on the way down. You just gotta look at it. What else to do? But look at it. The heat's making it harder. I'm too hot to touch. With my anything but my gloves, and that I got a sock over the edge of it. I didn't have to crawl into the truck to reach it. Sit on the board now. I can't sit on that edge. Keeping my little sock there just to keep from burning myself when I scoot over without thinking. getting hotter. It gets hot fast when the sun gets on. This time we need you don't want this on here first. You want to put that, and then I'll put my ground strap, and don't drop it, and then I'll put my quarter 20 with a washer. I think that'll work good. I don't know, I didn't have them all like that. I had that washer and lock washer on one of these, probably this one, I don't know, but I want that to have plenty of thread to go down in there. So I think that's better the way it is now than the way I had it before. Hopefully, unless I knew something that I don't know right this minute. There. Yeah, looks good. I meant to sand up that ground strap. It wasn't rusty, but you know, with all the oil and stuff. I think it'll be fine though. The oil will keep it from being rusty, and all that pressure should make it get contact. It's rusty back there. I think it's alright. Especially since it's really oily. But I did mean to. Wasn't sand it while it was off, but you know what? I'll do it when it's not so hot if I have any reason to believe it needs it. As long as I don't forget all about it forever. Okay. Bottom's running. Let's flip this all over. Because if I can get my light and look it over with, I can't see it all that good. Okay. Don't want any plug wires touching the headers or anything like that. Any of these wires on anything hot. I'll take off the air cleaner one more time and look everything over. Oh yeah, if I'm gonna see why it's not getting fuel, I need to have it off. Anyway. There's solid full of fuel there. And now I shouldn't have a leaky anything, so. See if I have my plug wires where they should be. Yeah, I guess that's alright. That intake gets kind of hot too, but that conduit, I always say the wrong thing. That stuff will, it's actually not the cheap stuff like I have over here on these. It won't melt real easy, so I've never had it melt. I'd like it be. I think it's been laying there on that for all these years. Yeah, it has. Okay. I don't have any giant vacuum leaks or anything. Be something if that's what it was. I really believe it's starting for fuel. The distributor's not loose or. None of the wires on here are loose. Uh-oh. What's that? I had some tape on that. It has writing on it. I don't know what it said. I think it probably said negative. Did I not have any electrical tape? I must have done that so that when next time I got in there, I wouldn't say, whoa, there's a wire missing. It's probably for hooking up a tack or something. Oh, I see. There's actually a connector on there. Is that a broken wire? Can't see from here. I may have to crawl around. Let's see. Let's try looking from here first. I got that phone mount up there. I don't have a phone on it. It doesn't stay in there very good. When you move it, phone will run down if I don't have it plugged in. That's a connector. Did I just find something? The fact that it had that big piece of tape on it. Out of a place. I think I need to go around to the other side. It won't be as hot over there. The sun's not on that side so much. So I believe I'll do that. I think I'll take the other camera with me. Show what it is I've discovered, but I think I marked it so that I wouldn't think that something goes there, but there's a connector with no wire in there. Female connector just stuck on the deal. On the male connector. I remember always going around and around with that, but I don't remember exactly what was what. I know I rewired it, I can see that. I kind of remember doing that. First, I guess. Get a drink. Trying to carry this around there. It's already running and it seems okay. It's hung up in there. Well, there we go. I can drag the cord with me. Boy, there's a nice breeze and I didn't even know it because I was in the sun. There's no sun on this side really. I think I might survive over here. There is right here by the tire, but I'm going to be up on the hood. Well, there is right there in the front, too. I don't know where the camera's going to need to be. That could be aiming at my area. Oh! Where I was looking. Yeah. Just down low. I don't know if I can get this one up in there anywhere or not. Hold it down there for a minute. It's up there, and you see those, the red wire with the yellow connector? Well, onto this, look forward towards the camera, there is a connector that's no wire on it. And that's the one I'm wondering. I'm going to crawl up in here where I can really look. And I can't put the camera anywhere where I can see that any better than the one up on the front, so I'll just leave it. I guess I'll stop this one for for a minute here. You know what, I'll do this. I've done it before, and there's been times when it was the only camera that ended up still running. So I'm gonna put this like this and just aim it in a wide shot. I even noticed you could hear a lot of what I was saying. So, because I keep having cameras quit on me. Okay. Alright, go back up there. One more sip of water, please. Yeah, see the back camera, you can see what I'm doing. Sitting, fidgeting or something. I gotta move that dirt thing. I'll just put it over here.
Gasket.
try starting it. See if the carburetor is not squirting any gas, so there's fuel in the filter but not coming out of the carburetor. So I'm going to start it. Maybe it'll run on that carburetor cleaner. And I might spray some starter fluid in there too to try to get it running again for a minute. Dripping, not squirting the jet, but dripping lots of gas. I wouldn't want to try to use former gasket on all that intricate stuff in the carburetor because you're going to plug up all the air jets and the fuel jets, not jets, but transfer tubes inside the carburetor, transfer channels, however you say it. I'm going to start it again. Let's see if it'll run long enough for me to kind of listen around now. Thank you. this set. Take this one with me, do a little listening. Running rough, and now my power cord came loose. Not really smoking anymore. Doesn't sound good, but it's better than it was yesterday. Let's go see if we can go to the backside, the other backside. I couldn't make it with my cord around the back. Better on this side. Still think maybe it's not sucking back on me. If it was sucking back, you'd have valve problems. Leaky valves, I believe. I remember a little test, but I don't exactly remember what they represent sometimes anymore. But I think those plugs did help. I bet you that one plug that I found broken, that it was not working at all, that it was dead and broke, you know, inside, and I just finished the job there. See if I can rev it up. All right, see if the valve cover's loose. Valve cover seems fine. I think it's just the one that I smelled earlier. I smelled it. Thought I better check. fix nothing. We figured out what two things are wrong, though. That hose soaked my butt completely. Guess it might have been good that I had that sock rag in there to kind of soak some of that up. And paper towel. Look at that. Probably soiled already on that camera. You know, I don't want to climb all the way back there. It's yeah, it's a good time to quit. Pants are soaked. It's too hot. Figure out something. Well, I figured out a couple of things.
Huh?
Figured out a couple of things.
Yeah.
I kind of had a suspicion that I might look probably at that right there. I took the cover off and go through. A lot of trouble trying to figure out what's wrong. Well, it seemed like it wasn't getting fuel, not that it was getting too much. So, and then you can see whether it's getting fuel or not. Oh! The sun's finally moving around. Huh? This one, I guess. Okay, so let's turn the camera around this way while I get a drink of water. Yeah, I think I'll sit down in the chair and get a drink of water. I'll probably have to stand here for you to hear me with the fan going on. At least the fan's on me in here. Oh. If you're thirsty enough, hot water tastes good. I got to where it would rev up after it warms up a little bit, but when you give it, I can't see both the, but the passenger side jet, when you open it up a little bit, it's two sets of jets in there. I'm not sure if that's the accelerator pump jet or the normal jet, but it just drips, gobs, and it's flooding it out. The one, I tried to see the other side, and I really couldn't get in a position to see it, and I kept wanting to die when I gave it gas. And yeah, I did. I was able to open up the secondaries, and it'll rev when you do that. You heard that on the camera. And you heard how they do. So, yeah, the carburetor needs rebuilding, I guess. really the only good way to do it. I could take it apart.